हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द प्रीवियस टॉपिक ऑफ क्लास 11 फिजिक्स. इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिराइव्ड द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ रिजल्टेंट एंड द एंगल व्हिच अ वेक्टर सपोज ए, अ वेक्टर ए मेक्स विद द रिजल्टेंट वेक्टर आर. वी हैव डन दिस पर्टिकुलर, वी हैव डन अप टू दिस पॉइंट इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो. सो going to continue from that video, if we have a particular case that when two vectors are right angle to each other, when two vectors are right angle to each other. So we have this particular case related to same previous article, when two vectors are right angle to each other. That is, in this case you have to consider the value of theta equal to 90 degrees. You have to consider the value of theta equal to 90 degrees. Again, we have, as we have seen in our previous video, that the value of resultant is given by root a square plus b square. The value of resultant is given by root a square plus b square plus 2ab cos of theta. So if two vectors are at right angle to each other, that means that theta is equal to 90 degrees, and theta is equal to 90 degrees means that cos 90 is equal to what and sin 90 is equal to what. By the simple trigonometric terms, sin 90 is equal to 1 and cos of 90 is equal to 0. So using these two values to obtain the value of resultant, we ended with the value of resultant equal to root a square plus b square plus 2ab multiplied with 0, 1. Of course, multiplied with 0, and thus the value of resultant becomes equal to under root a square plus b square. Nothing we have done. If two vectors are acting at right angle to each other, that means that the value of theta given to us is 90 degrees. And if theta is equal to 90 degrees, we can overcast or we can continue from that particular point in a very easy way. So in this way, we have done with the value of resultant and how the value of tan beta can be given for this particular case. We know the formula of tan beta is equal to b sine theta by a plus b cos of theta. Here theta is equal to 90 degrees, so we obtain this particular value of tan of beta. So this is one of very simple case, that what is the value of tan beta, or if you want to calculate the value of beta, that is tan inverse of b by a. What is the value of beta, tan beta, and the value of resultant for the case when the two charges or when the two vectors are present at right angle to each other. The next thing is, what are the conditions for zero resultant vector? What are the conditions for the zero resultant vector? What are the conditions for the zero resultant vector? So what we have to do in this term, if three vectors which are acting on the point charge simply means a very small charge. If three vectors are acting on the point charge are represented by the three sides of the triangle, if three vectors acting on the point charge are represented by the three sides of the triangle, are taken in same order. I am going to tell you what is the meaning of this line, taken in same order. Are taken in same order, then the resultant is zero. Then the resultant is zero. So if three vectors along the three sides of triangle are taken in same order, then the resultant is zero, which simply means that suppose I have these three vectors. This is vector 1, this is suppose vector 2, and this is a vector 3. Same order means that if you remind our triangle law of vectors, I have told you that how to represent the resultant when we have two vectors. और जो थर्ड वेक्टर उसकी डायरेक्शन चेंज हो जाती थी. ये क्या केस है, तीन वेक्टर सेम ऑर्डर में है. पहले हम यहाँ से यहाँ गए, फिर हम यहाँ से लेकर के यहाँ तक गए, फिर हम यहाँ से लेकर के यहाँ तक आए. ये है सेम ऑर्डर. अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू रिपीट. फर्स्ट वी हैव गॉन फ्रॉम हेयर टू हेयर, देन फ्रॉम हेयर टू दिस पॉइंट, एंड देन फ्रॉम हेयर टू दिस पॉइंट. सो वी आर यूजिंग द सेम साइड, वी हैवंट चेंज अवर डायरेक्शन. डायरेक्शन चेंज डजेंट मीन्स दैट वी हैव मूव टू वेस्ट, वी हैव मूव टू नॉर्थ. दैट सिंपली मीन्स दैट ऐसे गए, फिर ऐसे गए, फिर ऐसे गए. ऐसे हम लोगों ने कंटिन्यू किया. एरो ऐसे 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 गई, कोई भी एरो ने अपने डायरेक्शन को चेंज नहीं किया. दिस इज टर्म्ड एट सेम ऑर्डर, एंड इफ सच केस इज प्रेजेंट देन द वैल्यू ऑफ रिजल्टेंट इज नथिंग बट इक्वल टू जीरो. Then the value of resultant is nothing but equal to zero. And if such case is followed, then the object is in equilibrium. If such situation is followed, then the object is in equilibrium. Object equilibrium में होगा अगर ऐसी कोई भी situation follow की जाएगी तो. Next is some important facts about vectors. What are the important facts related to vectors? Vector addition is commutative. This means that A plus B is equal to B plus A. This is the meaning of commutation law. Vector addition के commutative होने का मतलब है कि a plus b, b plus a के बराबर होता है. That is the meaning of simple thing that vector addition is commutative in nature. और a plus b is equal to b plus a means that the vector addition is commutative in nature. Therefore, continuing to the next property. The next property is vector addition is associative. Which means that A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. Here we are going to have the brackets in this portion. This thing means that if we add A plus B and then add C to it, again I am repeating, if we add A plus B and add C to it, that is equal to the simple thing that we have added B plus C and added A to it. The bracket is with B plus C, and in this side on the left side the bracket is with A plus B. So this is our two important and simple laws, that vector addition is commutative and on the same side it is associative in nature. Vector addition is commutative and the vector addition is associative. Now let us consider an important and a simple question. What is our question? Two forces, we have two forces having the value equal to 5 newton and 20 newton are acting at an angle of 120 degrees between them. Find the resultant force. Find the resultant force and the direction related to it. You have given two forces. These forces are having some angle between them. You have to calculate the value of resultant force and the direction related to it. That question simple means that you have given the two values. You have given force. The two vectors are basically given to you. Now, first vector is having force the value of 20 newton. Second vector is having the value of 5 newtons. And the angle is equal to 120 degrees. We know by our basic information that R is equal to root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos of theta. That is equal to 20 square plus 5 square plus 2 into 20 into 5 into cos of 120 degrees. I have done nothing but I have simple eliminated A, B and theta by 25 and 120 value respectively. I have written, I have used those values. उन values को use किया और कुछ नहीं किया. कैसे है नहीं समझ आता कि cos 120 की value कैसे आई है, लिख लो. When the classes will start, I am going to explain that simple thing to you also. Cos 120 is equal to minus 1 by 2. You have studied this in math. And if you have some problem, I am going to consider that for you. The value of resultant becomes equal to root 325. The value of resultant becomes equal to root 325. So the value of again the tan beta is given by equal to B sine of theta by A plus B cos of theta. That is equal to 5 sine 120 by 20 plus 5 cos of 120, and sine 120 is equal to root 3 by 2 20 plus 5 into cos 120 is equal to minus 1 by 2. By simple calculation, tan beta becomes equal to 0.274. You can यहीं इसी स्टेप तक आप लोग कर दीजिए, कोई इतनी नीड नहीं है बीटा को निकालने की. सिंपल क्वेश्चन कुछ नहीं किया, ए और बी की वैल्यू दी गई थी, थीटा की वैल्यू दी गई थी. वी हैव जस्ट यूज द टर्म्स इन अवर पर्टिकुलर पोजीशन. ए की जगह 20 ले लीजिए, बी की जगह 5 ले लीजिए और थीटा की जगह ले लीजिए 120. इस सिंपल सी चीज का यूज करके रिजल्टेंट की वैल्यू को निकाल लीजिए, कैलकुलेट कर लीजिए. विद दिस we can consider one very easy numerical again related to this portion only. That numerical means, or what that numerical tells us is that a force ten newton and 14 newton are acting ऑन अ बॉडी. एक बॉडी पर 14 न्यूटन का और 10 न्यूटन का फोर्स एक्ट कर रहा है. फाइंड मैक्सिमम एंड मिनिमम रिजल्टेंट. क्या नया है इस क्वेश्चन में? दो फोर्सेस दिए गए, यानी कि पहले वाले क्वेश्चन की तरह ए की वैल्यू दी गई है और बी की वैल्यू दी गई है. The value of A and B is given to you all. So, the value of A and B is given to you. You have to calculate the value of maximum resultant and minimum resultant. The value of maximum resultant is equal to, याद रख लीजिए, A plus B. Maximum resultant होता है, दोनों vectors जो दिए गए हैं उन्हें add कर दीजिए. तो इस तरीके से maximum resultant बन गया 24. And the minimum resultant is given by subtracting the two vectors. A 10 है, B 14 है. कितना बन जाएगा? माइनस 4. तो जो मिनिमम रिजल्टेंट है वो माइनस 4 है. मतलब अभी तक हमने क्या कंसीडर किया कि रिजल्टेंट का फॉर्मूला होता है रूट ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस 2ab cos थीटा. अब एक नई चीज हम लोगों ने क्या देखी कि मैक्सिमम और मिनिमम रिजल्टेंट कैसे निकालते हैं. मैक्सिमम रिजल्टेंट का मतलब है दोनों वेक्टर्स को ऐड कर दीजिए और मिनिमम का मतलब है उन्हें सबट्रैक्ट कर दीजिए. सो ओके, वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू. next topic from another video. Thank you.